Okay, so here's a typical word problem that we have to write into an algebraic expression. They'd give us a story. Here, they tell us that last week, Sean had half as many computer games as Johan. He purchased 3 more games this week. Write an expression that represents the number of games Sean now has if J represents the number of games that Johan has. So basically what they're saying is J, right, that is equal to what Johan has in terms of games. So Johan's games. Based on that, they're saying, how much does Sean have? So what do we know? Well, first of all, Sean had half as many games as Johan. So Johan is this number of games, J. Multiply that by a half, right, or divide by 2, and you get a half. And that's how many games that Sean had. But that was last week. So that's the first part. Then he purchased 3 more games this week. So whatever he had last week was half as much as what Johan has. This week, he has 3 more. So here's an expression you could use, right, to figure out the number of games that Sean currently has. And if you're not feeling comfortable about this, pick a number of games for Johan to have. Let's say Johan has 12 games. Well, last week, Sean has half as many games as Johan. So Sean would have 12 divided by 2, or 12 times a half, which is how I wrote it, which equals 6. So Sean had 6 games, but then he purchased 3 more, right? So Sean would have 6, and then add 3 to that, and he would have 9 games. Does this equation give us the right number of games? Let's plug it in. J is 12. 12 times a half, right? And then add 3 to that. Well, that's 6 plus 3, right? And that's 9. So this equation does work. It gives us the right number of games for at least that situation, and it certainly would for any other. All right, thanks.